Okay, so today I will be teaching you how to animate a character from Photoshop and then moving it into After Effects and making it walk. So first you want to start with Photoshop, and I already made a project, a little character, just made a little bulldog, and you can see in the left or the right layer area, I basically made a layer for everything. So then you have his back leg, you have front leg, you have all these different layers. And you also, when you make a character in Photoshop, if you're going to do this, you want to make sure that if you are to make legs move, you want to, make sure you have body underneath it completely filled in, because if you don't and you move a leg, it's going to be clear, it's going to be an empty space. So you want to make sure you clear all of it, or add color to all of it. So basically from here, you're just going to save as, and you want to make sure you keep it saved as a PSD file. You want to make sure the layers, you can edit those, and you'll just save like that. I already have it saved, so I'm just going to open it up in After Effects. To do it in After Effects, instead of just opening a project, since you saved it from Photoshop, you actually want to import the file, so import file, and then find that project. So there's my project. Open. And then make sure also, for the composition, the layer options, you want to do the editable layer style, so you get all of the options to do all the layers. Okay, and the whole point of editing this animation is to make him look like he's walking. So I'm actually going to do a new composition size. So you go composition settings. And I'm going to change this to about 1500, and this one, I'm just going to wing it, maybe like 900, I don't know, or anything really works, just make it wider. Okay, so after you change the composition size, we're going to make everything attached to the main area, the body. So right this layer, the body layer. So basically what you want to do is you just have to press shift, hold it, and then just scroll up, press it all, and then you're going to use this thing. It's called a pick whip. And you're just literally going to drag it onto the body layer. And you can see on the right, everything is connected to the body. They're parent to the body. Alright, and from there, after that, we're gonna see the anchor points, which is this thing right here. Let me click out of this. So, let's try the front left leg, which is this layer. Okay, so basically when you press this layer, all you have to do is you can just hit R, and you can see this is the degrees of it. We're just going to see where this rotates and if it rotates properly. So you can see, obviously, that's not how a dog moves his arm. If it did, it'd be creepy. So we're just going to move it back to its original setting. And all you have to do from here is you just have to press Y, hold it down, and then drag this anchor point over to where an arm would actually kind of move. So, yeah, if about there would be good. And you can see this leg is not long enough to do it, so we can edit that and draw and paint and make it fit. So, let's do that. Okay, and to edit a certain layer, say something isn't matching up right and you want to fix it a little bit, all you have to do is double click on the layer, and then you can see you want it to turn, well, out won't turn because we have to edit it. So basically, you just have to paint. So there's a paintbrush at the top. Let's get rid of this. And then you should have paint. If paint isn't in that window, all you have to do, or is in your side panel here, all you have to do is go into window, and then you just press paint, and it'll show up. So basically, I need white. And I'm going to make this a little bigger, probably like 13, yeah, 19 probably. So just make it, this is just a little cheat way to do it, but you could just literally draw a little more extra room on the thing, or on the leg here, so that matches up. So if you turn it, there won't be any of those missing pieces there. Alright, and then after that, you're going to just switch colors, go make it look just like how the original is. I have a siding on the side here, so I'll just draw that on. Just fix this one. Alright, and that's really all you have to do. And just exit at the top, and it'll bring you right back to your composition. Also, bring this layer behind the body so it blends in. So now if you rotate this, you see there's no like missing parts there. Alright, and from here, after checking this, you can see the legs moving fine. It's moving where it should be. You just do the same thing basically to all the other legs. So your back leg here, let's press R. Oh, no. Click on your back leg, press R to rotate, see what it looks like. And it's a little off. And so thick member, press Y, hold it down. Move it to where it should, the anchor point, so where it would look okay, and that looks good. Alright, and then you have your right leg, press R again. And that one's pretty good, honestly. I don't really think that needs that much done to it since it's right there. And then finally, you have your back leg. So, press R again. And this one I figured was going to be a little bit trickier. For this one, I think I'm gonna edit it again. You can see that there's a little bit of a white spot there. So, double click on that one. Or actually, not the leg. Double click actually on the body. Fit. And then I'm just basically just gonna bring this line down. That's, oh, not there. Basically just bring the line down and makes it. Alright, let's just see what that looks like. So which leg was it? This back leg. It's a little off. I just gotta fix it up a little. That's it. Alright, so basically I fixed the back leg. It's not really gonna move that much. But I mean, I'm gonna fix the anchor point there. So, there. That looks pretty good, actually. Okay. And so, I'm pretty sure all of them are actually good. And from here, we're actually going to start setting keyframes. So, we're going to click on the front right leg, which is that one right here. And all you have to press R, and you can see there's a stopwatch picture that comes up here. You want to press that because that will set a keyframe. And this is what your keyframe looks like. So if you just move this just a little forward, however far you really want, you can adjust your arm So we're going to move that forward like that. So, and then if you play it back, you can see the arm moves. So basically, you're going to do that for all of your legs. But, and also remember, if you do a dog, it's a little trickier. Your legs have to move the opposite. So this, like, it's just double the work, kind of. So these two legs go together, and then this leg and your back leg go together. So keep that in mind. It's a little harder. All right. Set the keyframe, move it forward, and then move it forward. Same to this one, aim to your front left, press on it, press R, move this back. Move this the opposite way. They kind of overlap each other. And then you also need your back leg here. Bring this back. Remember to always bring, always bring your current time indicator back, so you don't mess up the keyframe position. So again, stopwatch, move it forward, and then bring it backwards actually. Alright, so basically, you play that back, all the legs move. So now, after that, you're just basically going to keep doing that. Just keep doing that until as long as you want it to do it. Like, I'm going to do mine for at least 7 seconds. And that's really all. Okay, and then also, you don't keep pressing the stopwatch. If you press the stopwatch, all your keyframes actually will go away. You should either press the keyframe button here, or you just move your current time indicator down the line some, and then you can just, all you have to do is hit the function you want. So right here, I'm moving the arm back to its main position, and then same thing basically with all of them. This one. Okay, so basically after you continuously do keyframes for at least like 7 seconds or so, however long you really want to do it, you can see the line of them here, and I'll just press play for you. So basically just press space bar and it'll play. So you can see how the dogs are moving, all the legs kind of move together, which is great. Okay, so next step here, we're going to change the position of the character. So say like you want them, okay, so basically make sure you click on the body layer. So now with positioning, just press P, and then your position tab came up. Same thing as basically the rotation thing. You get your stopwatch and then the name of it. This part's a little different though. So basically, I'm just going to move this here. And then for position, press the stopwatch. And you can move, press the stopwatch, move the keyframe along. So about to here or so. Wherever the dog stops moving. So basically you can do this, and then all you do is for this, you drag across. You can basically just keep it like this. Depending on where you want the dog to move to. So you can see this line, if that's the path it's going to take. Okay, so obviously here's your pathway. If you hit the space bar, it'll play through. The dog will move exactly in the direction you want it to go. And it's rendering a little bit, so it's a little slower than I'd like, though. So that's really all you have to do in that case. If you want to do something more, you can. If you want to add a background, I actually have one saved on here. So same thing you have to do for the actual project. You have to import, and I have this background. It's pretty long, so I'm gonna add this. And so get from your project panel, and then put it underneath your body. So there's that. And then also to scale an image, make sure the layer's clicked. Press S, and you just scale that down to where you're comfortable with. And that's really all you have to do in that portion of it. It's rendering, so again, it's a little slow. I'm going to speed it up a little bit. But yeah, that's really all you have to do in that moment. Another cool thing you can do, though, is you can make the background move. If you don't want to do the position change, you can just move, unlike the position change on the dog, you can just position the background to move, which I also think is pretty cool. Okay, so basically, to position it, you hit your stopwatch, there's your keyframe, is at the very bottom here. You just move it along for long enough to where, the dog's just walking, so wherever he stops, really, that's where you want your position to be about here. You want to still be able to see the legs move. Okay, so from there, you'll just move it backwards, and then you can't really move it that far, though. Let's see how this all looks together. And again, it's rendering. Okay, so the background didn't end up how I wanted it to exactly. So I'm gonna switch. I'm actually gonna just delete the keyframes. I'm also gonna delete that one. I'm going to bring this all the way back. Okay. So this way, again, So bring your thing all the way back to where the dog starts moving. So about there, so press your position, their stopwatch there, drag it to the end, and then all you have to do here is just pull the screen back, and it'll look like your dog's moving. Really just animates it more. Okay, so we're gonna play it back. Also, gonna play it back a little bit, let this render. While it's rendering, it usually is a little bit slower. So, let's just see. So now the whole background is moving. It's a little animated. You could speed it up if you wanted to. Really doesn't matter. But basically, yeah, that's really all it takes just to animate. It's very, very easy, a little time consuming, but it's worth it at the end, I think. So, alright, so I hope you enjoyed my video. Also, remember to save it. So save as. Yeah, just save as whatever. The Bulldog Project. And that's... So basically save that, and that's really all it takes. And you can add anything else in there, any more animations. I personally did. This is based off a video I've already done. But it's basically so simple. So, again, I hope you enjoyed it. And I hope you learned something.